Welcome back to Grow Maxx. I'm Super Dave again, and we're going to show you how to mix cutting-edge solutions today. A lot of people get intimidated by multiple bottle systems. It's not something you need to be concerned about. What's important is that you follow the manufacturer's recommended dosages or mix to half that when you start. A lot of manufacturers really juice up their PPMs trying to get you to use a lot of nutrients. Cutting Edge is a very stable, very good nutrient that doesn't really do that. When you're in soil, you can mix this stuff right per their chart. Works fantastic. What I'm going to show you today is how to mix it for hydro or aeroponics in specific. Now, it's a six bottle system, six parts, very simple. It's got a basic system similar to the GH if you want to run just a three bottle. There's a bloom, a grow, and a micro. Now, these three bottles here, very inexpensive. You can run these and have great results. However, I'm trying to push these plants, so I'm running their full nutrient package, including the Plantamp, Magamp, and the Uncle John's blend, which has got a whole bunch of things in it that your plants just love. So to start off here, what I have is a chart that is available anytime. If you send me an email at growmaxx, G-R-O-W-M-A-X-X, @yahoo.com, I'll send you a copy of this electronically. What this is a dialed-in cutting-edge solutions nutrient feed chart that we have specifically made for hydroponics. And it's dialed back to about the 50% range of what you can use in soil because hydroponics is so effective. So I'm going to start here and just mix this up and show you. Now I got a bucket of water here that's got some RO water in it. It's maybe like 3 gallons or so. You never ever want to mix a nutrient in full concentration together. You always need to dilute it into the water. Now Cutting Edge says I should add my micro first. Well, the micro is a nice thick micronutrient formula, stains, but there are no colors in this. A lot of companies, like, well, there's other three-part systems that have specific colors. They add food coloring into those products. Cutting Edge, all basic, all natural. So it says 4 milliliters per gallon. So I multiply that times the 30 gallons I'm gonna have in here, and I get 120 milliliters. So that's what I have in here. So I'm gonna just pour that in, give it a little bit of a stir, go right on to my next one. Follow the chart again. Bloom, I'm in my bloom cycle. You can see we have blossoms hanging on here. So my bloom is the clear one. This gets 300 milliliters because it's 10 milliliters a gallon. Mix that up a little. Now we don't need any grow during the bloom cycle, so I'm not mixing in any grow. But the grow product is also part of the line when you're in veg or the transition stage. So the next one I'm going to have is Plant Amp. This right here is going to be your calcium supplement, and it's going to correct all your deficiencies, and it also has organic acids in it, which fluctuate your pH. This is a pH stable line. Once you mix this, you don't have to worry about your pH. I run this system all the time without any pH adjustments for 10 days between changes. So I'm going to put this in, and your pH is going to drop quite a bit. I often see down into the fours, into the high four numbers. But I'm not worried about it, because within a day or two, those organic acids release, go into the plants, and then your pH naturally rises. So, and then the next blend, this is going to be the Uncle John's blend. This has got all kinds of good things your plants love, and a couple of boosters that really kick production in. Your very last nutrient is going to be the Magamp. This is going to be your magnesium supplement. Now this, we're at about 60 milliliters, and one of these very close to the top is just about there. So that's good enough. I'm not trying to over-mag them. Mag also works really good for low light situations, and it helps speed up the processes that are happening in the plant, giving you a faster finish. So this is already mixed. I'm going to pour it into our system here. You can see we just did a nutrient change. Right now there's just RO water in there, so we're giving it a little bit of a flush, letting all whatever it has built up, if any, flush out of the plants, give them a nice healthy new start with the new nutrients. I've been running it about 6 or 8 hours with no nutrients in it. So it's flush now, the cycles have kicked in, it's ready to be fed again. So I'll pour this in and we'll keep you updated. We're going to put the plant cage up here that we made out of PVC and get these plants supported, because as you can see from the hydrogen, no support. But again, you look at a Plant Maxx puck, these plants are standing up really nice and tall. Look at this big one. The next time you see this is actually going to be smaller than what it is right now, because I'm going to hack it. I'm going to take some cones here. Keep tuned. I'll show you the cloning video in just a minute.